Suppose we know that secant of theta equals w over square root of 3, and we want to know tangent of theta when theta is between 0 and pi over 2. So we know that secant of theta equals 1 over cosine of theta. And cosine of theta equals the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So that means the secant equals the hypotenuse over the adjacent side. So if we have secant of theta equals w over square root of 3, which is equal to the hypotenuse over adjacent, then we can say that w is the hypotenuse and square root of 3 is the adjacent side to the angle of theta. We're looking for tangent of theta, which is opposite over adjacent. So we need to find this opposite side. We already know our adjacent side. So if we call this opposite side y, then we know that y squared plus square root of 3 squared equals w squared by the Pythagorean theorem. So y squared equals w squared minus 3. So y equals plus or minus the square root of w squared minus 3. And we can know that we are plus or minus based on our angle theta. So this says that theta is between 0 and pi over 2. So if we have tangent of theta equals either plus or minus square root of w squared minus 3 over the adjacent side, which is square root of 3. So looking at our unit circle, if we're between the angle 0 and pi over 2, tangent is sine theta divided by cosine of theta, which is y divided by x. And both our y-coordinate and our x-coordinate are positive, so that means that tangent should be positive. Since this is what's determining our sine, that means that we must have the positive side. So tangent of theta, in this case, since theta is between 0 and pi over 2, is positive square root of w squared minus 3 divided by the square root of 3.